Joining us now to talk about this, Dr. Robert Murphy. He's a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning.
Let's talk about this pill for COVID.
Yeah, this is really exciting, and it's a 1 year overdue. There's a new program, antiviral program for pandemics, or APP. This is a $3.2 billion program launched by the Department of Health and Human Services to get a pill to treat COVID. Like we have Tamiflu to treat the flu. We have drugs to treat hepatitis C. We have drugs for other viral infections, for herpes, whatever. We don't have a really good drug to treat COVID yet, other than remdesivir, which can only be given intravenously. So these are pills. So there's three candidates. There's one, I have to actually look at how it's spelled, molnupiravir, that's its new name. This is being developed by Merck, developed originally at Emory University. AT527, a drug by Atea Pharmaceuticals, also in late stage development. And PF 07321332. This is a big long number, but this is by Pfizer.
Would those replace the vaccine?
No. This would be complementary.
I see.
But, you know, if you, you need actually for a pandemic, you need everything. You need vaccines, you need social mitigation, all the masks and everything. It all depends on where you are in the whole process, but pills are definitely part of it. You know, what if another variant comes out and all of a sudden the vaccine doesn't work? We need to have something in our back pocket. This is basically insurance.
What is your best estimate as to when these pills could be available?
Well, the article that I read when they announced this program on yesterday is the end of the year. The two of them, the Merck drug and the Atea drug, are in later stage development. So that could happen if they're going to put their foot to the pedal and get this thing moving. You know, the FDA dragged its feet a year ago when these drugs started to be developed. They were not helpful like they were with the vaccines. So, you know, better late than ever, you know, and if they can do a vaccine in less than a year, they should be able to get these out by the end of the year.
Before we get to viewer questions, quickly, I wanted to ask you about hundreds of vaccinated Indonesian health workers got COVID, dozens of them in the hospital. What does that say to you?
Well, yeah, that's a terrible thing. You know, Indonesia is, you know, a very heavily populated country, 350 healthcare workers, all vaccinated with Sinovac, the Chinese vaccine. They're sick. It's not just mild disease. They're in the hospital and whatever. I mean, these are the frontline workers. It's terrible. So in other words, the Sinovac vaccine doesn't work good against the Delta variant, which is predominant in Indonesia. This is really what we have to be careful about. Fortunately, our three vaccines do work for Delta.
All right, let's get to some viewer questions, starting with this. Is there anyone you think should not get the vaccine, certain allergies, treatments, et cetera?
Yeah, if anyone is allergic to any of the components of the vaccine, which are listed in their package insert, and any doctor can go look at them, these are usually people who have a lot of allergies. And we get a lot of questions about this. But if you're allergic to any of those components, you have to find a vaccine that doesn't have that component that you're allergic to. Rare.
Okay, this next question. I got the Johnson & Johnson vaccine in April. Ever since, my sense of taste has been off. I went to see my doctor. She told me that it is not listed as a side effect of the vaccine. I'm convinced otherwise. When the vaccine wears off, is it possible my sense of taste will return?
Yeah, no, this is very interesting because it's also a side effect of COVID. So, you know, if this was temporarily related to getting the vaccine, I believe the patient. I mean, come on, this happened. This is not, losing your sense of taste is very unusual. So there's a way to report this. You know, we didn't even know that loss of smell was related to the infection because doctors don't normally ask, hey, are you smelling okay today, you know? So, you know, it took a while to actually pick that up, and it's a very common side effect. So there's a form that anyone can fill out, you don't have to be a medical person. It's called the VAERS form, V-A-E-R-S, and you can just file it yourself or your doctor can file it and say you have it. And then the FDA keeps all this stuff, and when they see, oh, here's another taste one, there were 10 other ones here, everyone's ignoring it, but they'll put it all together. So that's what I would suggest. The good news is all these kind of strange side effects that are popping up typically go away in a matter of months.
All right, doctor, thanks so much for joining us. If you have a question for Dr. Murphy, head to our Morning News Facebook page, post it there. We'll talk to him again on Monday. Have a good weekend.